started with computers when I was a kid, when we had to build them ourselves. Programming was already an amusement. In the late 80s, I graduated as an engineer and joined a small French software vendor that pioneered artificial intelligence, iLog, or eLog in French. Then I joined highly qualified and creative developers and architects. One of them was a guy called Akim Eridi, who was working on building a structured graphic library in C++. He immediately became my mentor and taught me everything I would need to know regarding what an industrial software library should look like and how to expose it to end users properly. When Akim left in 94, I became the head of what would be the visualization product line, iLog. My team and I worked at leveraging, you know, the graphical platforms and programming languages that were popping up every frequently at that time, like Java, Flex, or .NET. This is where I made most of my career. From the company standpoint, my title is CTO, so I try to ensure that the technologies that we use will cover the needs of our users without exposing too much of their complexity. On the Taipy project, I'm directly in charge of the graphical user interface generation part, with the same objective, rely on widely accepted technologies that complement each other to provide a maximum added value with as little deep knowledge as possible from the user standpoint. Vincent Gosselin, the company's CEO, and I worked together at iLog ages ago. He called me at the beginning of 2021 with the idea of simplifying the development of potential complex applications for data analysts. He had everything in mind except for the user interface part, which he thought was mandatory. As he's been following my career in that domain, he naturally asked me for my opinion. The challenge was to provide ways for Python developers to be able to design graphical interfaces with no skills whatsoever in front-end development. After a few weeks, I gave him a proposal he seemed to like, so he asked me to join and so I would oversee that part of the project. Well, the point of Taipy, just like basically every software library I've been participating in for decades, is to provide high-level features that are reliable, robust, efficient, and require as little understanding of the underlying plumbing as possible. The resulting proposal is a set of Python packages that one can pick for free and build on immediately with impressive productivity. You can, with little knowledge of the Python language and libraries, create and deploy a complete application based on your own data, controlled by your state-of-the-art interactive interface that one can put in user hands with confidence. The cherry on the cake is that once you're happy with the application, you can immediately deploy it in a production mode. Taipy is just not yet another prototyping tool. It really provides all it takes to rapidly create industrial applications that can be deployed through the web in no time. So Taipy Studio is a Visual Studio Code extension that even lowers the bars in terms of how much code one needs to write to put Taipy in gear. You can literally draw your data flow, indicating how the data should be taken from, driven to, and where it should be delivered. The Python code that's needed to create all the pipes that drives data through mathematical algorithms really becomes minimal. A data scientist can then concentrate on the relevant task of creating the base data transformation code for a given objective. Taipy Studio also provides support for the declarative part of the user interface definition to greatly improve productivity. Well, as a data scientist that knows not much about Python and nothing at all about user interfaces, you can build and deploy your professional application concentrating only on the added value of your specific domain. That's true from the access to data to the definition of the data flow, up and to including the persistence of the results and user interfaces that let you and your end users access their business information, drive their application, deliver final displays to base decisions on, and all that for free.